It's Nicole Elliott with Studio Elliott Focus. Today I'm going to talk about photography burnout and what that's all about and three steps you can take to never burn out. Okay, so this is a really common story. I hear it all the time. Women that get into photography, or even men, that love it because they're so passionate about it and they're just excited about it. They start doing as many shoots as they can and they fill up their life with photography. Well, a year goes by and like, oh, this is great, but it's a lot of work. And then another year goes by and they're like, okay, this is just a lot of work, and now instead of owning a business, my business owns me. And I was blessed enough to be around many, many different pro photographers for 5 to 8 years, really, before I even started my own business. And I got to see the photographers that were super passionate about it and stayed passionate about it throughout their photography business, and then others that ended up just saying, it's just a business. I could care less. I shoot my clients the same way every time. I use the exact same lighting. It's very predictable. It has zero creativity. It just pays the bills. So I've seen both spectrums. And so before I even started my business, I thought, well, I'm going to do it the right way. I want to do it the right way right off the bat so that I never have photography burnout. So I just wanted to give you three simple tips on how to create a solid outline for your business that is going to help you to prevent that photography burnout, okay? So tip number one, shoot what you love, show what you love, okay? So this is huge. You have to shoot the things that make your creative spirit soar. If you start shooting things just because it's what your clients want you to shoot, or it's because it's what the area that you're in, it's all they shoot. You know, let's say you live on the coast and every photographer shoots on the beach and that's just kind of the photographer you feel like you need to be, but really that's not your passion. You want to shoot somewhere totally different than where other people are shooting. You need to do that. You have to shoot where you're passionate about shooting, even if it goes against the grain in your area, because that is going to be the thing that makes you stand out, and that is going to be the thing that gives you the driving force to continue even when business gets hard. If you're not passionate about what you're shooting, that's where you're going to end up just fizzling out. You're going to end up hating it. So shoot what you love, and then what I mean by show what you love, now those images that you're super stoked about, that you just, your creative spirit comes alive when you shoot it, that is what you show online. That's what you show on Facebook. That's what you show on your website. You don't show any other pictures than that. Now, in every shoot that I do, I get the shots that's like, you have to look at the camera and smile. You have to do those simple, kind of nothing type of shots because grandma and grandpa are going to love those shots. You got to get the grandma and grandpa shots. Now, are those the shots that you love to take? Maybe not, but you know that those are the shots that every household needs, right? The look at the camera and smile shots. Now from there, that creative side of your shoot, now that comes later. So what I always say with that is play it safe, then go crazy. Get all the shots that you know are like those safe shots. Then the second half of your shoot, you're going crazy, doing as many creative shots as you can. Those are the shots you show. You don't show those shots that it's like, just look at the camera and smile. You show the shoots that make your heart come alive. So that's how I, if you go to my web, well, my website is totally changing over. I'm doing my camera strap, my Studio Elliott Essentials camera accessories line. So I'm transitioning from photography into creating awesome camera accessories for the everyday photographer mom. But if you were to go to my website, you would not see many shots of girls or families or anybody smiling at the camera. There was probably zero, because that's just kind of not my style. My style is more, I want to tell a story with your face. I want to tell a story with the scenery. I don't love doing the big, huge, smiley stuff. That's just kind of not my style. And people know that, and that's why they go to me. So you want to develop your style and show what people, show what you are passionate about and nothing else. Okay. Number two, your clients fit into your schedule, not you into theirs. Okay. So prioritizing your schedule and making your schedule, planning it out at the beginning of the year is essential. It's the number one tip I learned from an amazing photographer. They said in January, you plan out your calendar and you say, all right, starting in, depending on what part of the country you're in, you set your shooting season. Okay. So for us, we live in the north and our shooting season is pretty short. We start shooting in about April-ish. And then we shoot through September and October because we have harsh winters, unless we're doing a winter snow shoot, which is super awesome. But so I usually started planning my shoots in April and in that springtime, and I would only do Tuesdays.